The first attribute of it is its name, Featherweight. But it was designed very, very carefully and perfectly. So your stitch quality is very consistent. Most of your quilters now are going to class, and all they're learning is quilting techniques that involve straight stitch.
They fold up like this, and then they go into a black case, and so it's, and they're very, very portable. The trouble with that is because they're so popular, the demand drives the price sky high, and people are asking, you know, probably $250 to $400 for a 221 and $1,000 and up for a 222 featherweight.
This is actually a Featherweight 222. In perfect condition, this machine would probably bring about $1,400 to $1,500. And a regular featherweight would bring about $400 to $500 in perfect condition.
I think they probably are overvalued. There's a certain amount of mystique that has built up around a featherweight that I think is out of proportion to the machine itself. I mean, they're wonderful little machines. They're very light. They're very portable. Quilters love them because they can take them from place to place. But the motors aren't particularly strong. It's like a 0.5 amp motor in them, so they're not particularly powerful machines.
And the motors are the big problem because they sell them for more than the machines are worth mostly, because without it, you know, you don't have a machine.
It is also the hardest one to unbind because it's made to such careful specifications. A very slight piece of thread can totally bind up the machine. So that's really its only shortcoming.
The parts are available for the featherweight. I would say that some of the bobbin cases that are coming out of China that are replacements for the featherweights are kind of dicey.
The bobbin case by itself is worth about $50. Just the bobbin case. This one's missing. Somebody used the bobbin case.
The covers, the front cover, the light switch they remove.
This lever, that lever, this foot, this plate, these plates, they don't make them anymore. And if somebody has one and needs one, they probably would sell the plate for $100.
You know, like the hand wheels, they sell them separately. Almost everything on the machine.
They can part these machines out and make more money than they would selling the whole machine.
I love them, but there are other alternatives that are much, much more affordable. Heavier, a little bit bigger, but still excellent machine. Over here, this is one called the Singer 185. Now, this happens to be a portable model. This came in a cabinet version as well. But this is only a little bit bigger. It is a metal machine instead of aluminum. But it's a bit heavier, but still an excellent little machine. It's a 3/4 size machine. This is actually under the hood, this is a Singer 99. Mm-hmm. They put it in a cool looking green case. The 99 is a 3/4 size version of the 66, which is one of the most popular and best engineered Singers ever. So this is a 3/4 size, so it's a little bit smaller. They put in a really cool green case. And these are available at very attractive prices. I picked this one up for, I think, $25.
People pride themselves in, you know, I bartered for it, I was at a yard sale, I got it on eBay. They just always love the stories. Every once in a while, oh, it was my grandmother's, but usually it's the going for the kill.